you're watching South Connect. This segment brings all the latest news and updates from the states of South. Let's go first to Andhra Pradesh. The Election Commission is likely to hold assembly polls in Andhra Pradesh, Orissa, Sikkim and Arunachal Pradesh in Lok Sabha elections due next year. The term of four assemblies will end in May and June of 2019. The sources also said that there are possibilities of holding elections to the Jammu and Kashmir Assembly dissolved this month before it completed its tenure along with the general election. Now let's move on to Telangana. When Telangana goes to poll on December 7th, many voters, possibly several lakhs of them whose name were deleted from the rolls of Election Commission's purification process, will not be able to exercise their democratic right to vote. The voters' deletion of about 27 lakh voters in the state was done using an error-prone software which mapped Aadhaar data with voter IDs and in many cases without following due process and without voters' consent. Today, the number of voters in Telangana stand at 2.73 crore, which is down from 2.82 crore voters in 2014, a difference of 9 lakh voters. The Election Commission claims these 9 lakh voters are those who had shifted out from Telangana to Andhra Pradesh after the state bifurcation in 2014. Now let's move on to Karnataka. Karnataka Chief Minister H.D. Kumaraswamy seems to have fallen back on his words on crop loan waivers after the December 5th deadline he had set to roll out the Rs. 38,000 crore scheme is set to get postponed by at least a few more months. The delay could trigger another farmer uproar in the state as they have been facing hostile weather changes including back-to-back droughts and resulting failure in Rabi and Kharif crops. Now let's move on to Tamil Nadu. A Delhi court on Tuesday framed charges of criminal conspiracy against former AIADMK leader T T V Dhinakaran in case related to the alleged bribery of Election Commission officials to get the two Leaves Party symbol. The court framed charges against Dhinakaran for the alleged offences punishable under Section 120B. The court fixed December 17th for commencing the trial by recording evidence in the case. That's all for today in South Connect. For more news updates, log on to www.hwnews.in.
If you like this video, please share it and we would love to hear your comments in the comments section down here. Also, please do like our Facebook page and follow us on Twitter to get minute-to-minute news updates. For more such shows and videos, well, subscribe to our YouTube channel.